Is this your style?
Nah, not at all, but it's so cool.
I thought this would be Scotty's style right here.
Nah, hell no.
What's going on, guys? Just touched down in LA. For those that don't know, I actually lived here from 2002 to 2012. Scotty and I have been here a couple times since then for trade shows and random things, but this is my first time to really get to chill in LA since I left to take on this journey with Scott. So excited to be here and looking forward to what's about to... Where's Ian? Turns out, we may or may not have left Ian at home, but we're gonna have a great time in LA. We are gonna do some shopping. We're gonna find some shoes. We're gonna find some clothes. We're gonna hit all the hot spots. First, we gotta go see our boy Drew over at the Hom Fem warehouse. We used to do all of his sales and distribution out of Dallas for several years. We started the store. He moved everything back to LA. So this is our first time getting to see the Hom Fem warehouse since that transition happened. So
only right we go visit Drew. First, we got the 745 black on black whip for the weekend. This BMW is nice. We need a lot of extra room because we're going back to Bape. We're going back to all the other stores, Chrome Hearts, you name it. And we need a lot of stuff that we can put all of our, you know, buys and everything in while we're whipping around through Rodeo and Fairfax and Melrose. So it's only right that we get something that's nice, but also spacey. You gotta leave?
Yeah, my flight to that shit, bro. Oh, y'all close. Y'all like literally right here.
Alright, bet that. He just rammed into the car.
Five minutes in, and I've already gotten ran into.
You hit the AC coolant, you can see it leaking. I got so much shit to do. So we're at that light right here on Santa Fe. Basically, he was got stuck in the middle of the intersection and just started backing up. And we were just holding the horn down, telling him not to. And he just didn't listen and backed all the way into the car and just kept backing into the car. I got so much shit to do and I don't have time to deal with it. We just got these badass shorts in. And if you wear them, you can play like Jordan
or LeBron. Or Master Chef.
You can jump higher.
Mad handles.
Can't handle this.
Buckets all day.
Oh, Kobe!
Designed by the top scientists of the world.
Cutting edge technology. Patent pending rubber stamp for aerodynamics.
Shorts work. Shorts work.
Go now to privateselection.com because this is limited. This is a special offer just for our subscribers. Go now, hurry, get this limited quantity shorts. These are the best basketball shorts ever.
Probably gonna be the craziest episode ever.
So Drew came and picked us up because it's around the corner from the warehouse.
I called Scotty 30 minutes ago. He's at the line. I'm like, where the fuck these dudes at? Like, I gotta go. What the fuck is this? And then I'm like, yo, where's the Zeus Scotty at? I was hot. And then I find out they get smacked by 18-wheelers.
Smacked. And the dude's mad at me. I'm like, bro.
How much would it cost so I can borrow your car?
Just give it. No, free, bro. Just give it to my brother the keys.
Are you fucking serious?
Why the fuck would I charge you to
use my car? It's my motherfucking boy right here. Oh, man.
Man, why not charge you to use my car, bro?
I don't know.
Just don't give it to no 18-wheeler wrecks.
Larry said to leave him so we can get this footage because we know that you're just going to close the shop.
Oh, go right now?
Yeah, let's go to the warehouse now. Larry said just to go.
Yeah, Chinatown's right here. We got two spots.
Yeah, right.
I'm still here. Yeah. Kill those for me.
All right,
kid.
Straight lay hand up.
So if you guys don't know, before Scotty was a superstar, he was always Scott. Before he had the store, he used to be like, yo, we want to start a store. So like 3 years later, they hit me up and they're like, look, got a store. But before that, he was Mr. Home Fin.
I was Mr. Home Fin, man. But in Dallas.
In Dallas.
So the warehouse used to be in Dallas. Moved it back to LA when we opened the store.
And it's crazy packed in here.
That's good.
This is our design room, but it's no one's here. It's clutter like everything else. It's like where we do all our concepts and stuff.
These are like the Jabos. So back in the day when we had the warehouse in Dallas, we would probably get orders would probably come in. They'd probably be about this much right here, I'd say, right, Drew? Something like that.
Yeah.
And it's like you got like seven times as much as that coming in as one drop. So that just lets you know what the growth is right now from this to seven times that size. And then look how far back that shit goes. This place is huge. This shit is crazy. Holy shit.
The craziest shit happened. We ended up getting all these boxes of hoodies. We were supposed to get them in November. My big homie Chris from The Leverage will tell you, a container ship wrecked for the first time in like 20 years. And a lot of people lost like all their packages and stuff. So we've been waiting like 6 months for those hoodies. They barely came in summer. We can't do nothing
with them. So now you're gonna run it for, I guess, next year's fall or this year's fall?
Bro, people probably come in here and fall in love.
So much. Goes for days.
So tell them about the Chris Brown, Freaky Friday, Little Dicky.
We had dropped these tracksuits 2017, yeah. I want to say.
2016.
And they'd been out for a couple months.
Yeah.
And then out of nowhere, you got called. You had to sign a waiver to let Chris wear it. I remember for the video for Freaky Friday with Little Dicky. And he posted it. And the music video went viral. You ended up promoting it as well. And the next thing you know, I mean, we took a long shot on that one and we threw the stock on the website and
sold 500 in one day.
Sold 500 in one day. And we'll show you the picture of me laying in the warehouse with all the packages. I built a whole house and slept on it like a bed full of packages to go. And we did 500 units in one day just off Chris Brown. So shout out Chris Breezy. Everybody out there really supporting that movement.
I got crazy stories with these dudes, man. I remember 2017, before that happened, we were all broke as fuck. Scott's like broke boys, future millionaires. We probably had like 2,000 to our name between the three of us.
Yeah.
And Scotty was like, don't trip, we're gonna all be millionaires in a few years. And I don't know about them, but I mean, y'all know about them. You already know. We good over here, man.
Yeah, it's BBFM for real.
We're blessed, man.
There's a story behind the brand, bro. I want to pick out some stuff. I want to pick some stuff out for Larry. I just don't know if Marcel is going to be around.
Yeah, Marcel's out, man.
Who else is going to be here? No one?
It's just me, and I got to go.
All right, let me be quick, then. This. I think I'm going to put it on with this. That's why I grabbed it.
Bro, I wish Larry could see.
Yeah, I know. We were literally just hyping it all up on the fucking airport and video before we got in the car.
Love you, bro.
Where are we going?
We're going to get Larry, right?
Yeah. Well, Larry, is it taken care of?
No, I have to call Turo and they got to come with their tow truck and come get it.
See you later, man. I got to go, guys. Paris calls.
All three?
Yeah.
I got mine too?
Yeah.
Damn, Drew.
Hey, didn't have to be this fast, but we'll go to Jamaica or something together, man.
Yeah.
Rich boys, current millionaires.
It's 4 o'clock. We got in a wreck at 12:45. It's been 3 hours since we've been able to do anything. Larry's been having to do paperwork, calling tow trucks, calling Turo, calling all these other places to get the car situated. We finally now made it out to our first destination. So come with us, let's go.
We see the toll stage line's long.
Well, you're talking about 4:30?
Oh, it's the gallery. That's what I'm saying.
I've never been to the store before. It's called 4:30, and it's almost 4:30. So we're gonna go check it out.
It's time to check it out.
Okay. There you go, Larry. You got the khaki pants on.
Rude.
About some of the same stuff. Cactus Plant, a little bit of Rude, Kanye, Certified Lover, Tekashi, Brain Dead. Larry, did you ever pass on this one? This isn't your size, but this looks like something you'd rock.
The Brain Dead.
They don't have a size yet.
Yeah.
They have a couple different ones, but they're all extra small. Good by Air. This is hard. Good by Air piece. Yeah, that's tight.
Might need this.
Look at this.
Is there more sizes in this color? Or is that the only one?
Unfortunately not.
Okay, I'll take this XL.
Okay, for sure.
Doesn't take Larry much to cop something off the rib real quick.
Sure. They just did a feature on us on Complex.
Nice, hell yeah.
But we so new, bro. We just made it to January, man.
Oh, yeah,
yeah. We fresh out.
Fresh out.
So we come from the music background. Like, Lil Mouse is my artist. Lil Mouse
Chicago?
Yeah,
of course.
It's my artist.
That's tight.
We learn as we go, but we killing it.
What are you, my man?
8760, man.
I'll buy it.
I'll buy it. No, a dope little brain dead piece. I got all the chucks, like. That's one of my favorite pairs of shoes. My brain dead Converse.
Oh yeah.
Oh, there it is.
Larry?
It's 4:30. We just spent some money at 4:30. So perfect timing.
Perfect timing.
I appreciate you, my man.
Thanks, man.
Love. Scotty, by the way.
Bugsy.
Bugsy. Larry, nice to meet you, man.
Let them know where to find you.
Yep.
You can find us at 4:30 Fairfax. That's us. I'm Bugsy certified. All love.
There it is.
Hi, Bugsy. Appreciate y'all.
Hey, thank you.
Anytime.
Woo, that looks good.
All right, guys, so we just pulled up to Sweet Chick. For those that don't know, this is Nas's restaurant. Obviously, the music selection has been fire, but now we got the food, so we got to see what the food's talking about. But so far, just from the look and the smell of it, pretty sure we're going to enjoy this right now.
You can say something.
This honey butter chicken biscuit looks good, but it's not a Whataburger honey butter chicken biscuit, but it's okay. We ain't counting.
Wow.
If we started a separate YouTube channel for food reviews, would you guys watch? Let me know in the comments.
Chicken was good. The mac was excellent. Fries is whatever. But the music is what's popping right now. Since Nas owns it, they're gonna be playing a lot of the old classics that Larry and I grew up listening to, so definitely a good feeling in here.
Give it the rating.
Out of what, 5 stars?
Sure.
I'd say 3.5, 4. Something like that, you know?
4. So 4. Really good. The chicken was the best. Fries are okay. Whatever this sauce was amazing. 4 out of 5. The froze is a 10 out of 10.
Damn!
Yo. Welcome to Sweet Chick. Sweet Chick on Instagram. Look us up and holla at us. Peace.
I went to 4:30. I picked one thing. It's a shirt by a brand called Braindead. Braindead is a collective of artists who put together these pieces. Different pieces will be done by a different artist. Scotty spotted the Braindead head up there, so had to pull up and
it's pretty
see
cool
if
though,
I can
look.
Find some more.
Strange Days, Conquer, Ghost in the Shell.
Sorry.
What's up, man? How y'all doing?
Good, man.
Hey, how are you?
I'm cool, man.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No worries. Thanks, Clive.
What's up, y'all? Welcome.
What's going on?
You guys come film in this.
Sorry.
Yeah. That's cool.
Yeah.
We just don't do videos, not space, sorry.
All right. We found a couple things. Full Fit Larry bought a full fit. Are you surprised? Me in New York with my Rick Owens on.
With your chopped cheese in
your
hand. Crazy.
No, when I had that hot dog at the end of the night.
Come on, bro.
Nobody would understand it, so it'd be kind of inappropriate right now. Yeah, show them the gift. Show them the gift.
Do you guys show pictures in here, or what do you tip it? Do you use this for anything?
Yeah, so we show movies from Wednesday through Sunday, and then we also rent it out for private events.
Super
so,
dope.
Yeah, we show lots of stuff.
This is really cool. Now the marquee out front makes sense with the
How
it looks like a movie theater. Yeah.
Thanks for sharing that with us.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, cool.
There you go.
Hey. I'm totally confused right now. If you look this way, there's grills by Scotty. Definitely gonna be hearing from my people. If not, then just give me a free iced out grill. I want VVS, visible set, top and bottom. I just want it to look like one big ice block going across my mouth like back in the day. You can't even see the teeth like lines. Yeah. It's just like one solid strip across your mouth.
All right, so y'all already know what it is. If you come to Melrose, one of the places you gotta hit is the Cool Kicks. Everybody knows that. So, first stop on Melrose is the Cool, and then after that, Cool Kicks. So, let's go check it out, see if we can find something.
Okay, well, we just got to the Cool. About to check everything out and see if there's anything we can find in here.
They got wide selection just like we do, so we'll take a look around.
We got the Paris, Swarovski, Louis Vuitton, CDC, Cashmere, Tommy.
They got a lot of BOGOs.
Their BOGOs are stacked.
All of us, we need them, bro.
Dessert.
And you can see their Yeezy section is the same size as our Yeezy section as far as like rare Yeezys. There's a tiny little box around the corner.
Those are the ones I want.
Biggest size is an 8.5. I want the OG, the white sole, not the gum bottoms. They don't put any of their stuff in plastic, though, I noticed, which is cool, but I gotta do that shit, man. Our stuff will get so dirty. I'm trying to find some like old BOGOs. Yeah, I'm doing great. Thank you.
Thought about it for half a second.
I think it was the other episode I was talking about. There's like the 9 infamous picture tees. This is one of them.
I got that Nas sitting out, large. Probably something that's 200,
450. I wish I was a medium. Little shrunk.
Hold on, they got some shit in here like that. Damn, poke it up. Medium.
That's the type of shit I'm trying to get right now. It's like a large XL and an old shirt. I don't care if it's crusted and cracked at all. This is what Larry wants.
Why do I have to take this abuse?
See the Emilio Pucci jacket? Did y'all get any of those shorts in?
Yeah, party out.
I only had one. I'm up and sold them.
I need the blue.
You want the color? Yeah.
It's not even that one. There's the pink one, the black. I got the blue one.
Yeah.
And I have the button up.
I knew we did have the blue one though. But I didn't just sold.
I brought it just in case I found the shorts while I was out here. But.
Super dope color, but it's a large. How much are the hose, Matt? How much are these?
60.
Do I get the orange camo? Or do I get the all orange? This one's got like more of a burnt orange to it, not like as bright. So we'll get this one.
13 men's. 400.
Somebody already beat those to shit? You don't want them anymore? Thank you. Appreciate it. Huh? Rap bait. They got like 7 stores all over the United States, like literally everywhere except for Texas. One of the cool things about bait is they got a lot of the toys that I collect here in store, along with a bunch of dope sneakers. They don't do too much with clothes, but vinyls and sneakers is one of their things. So let's go in here and look at a bunch of dope shit.
Doing a pretty good job of at least finding something everywhere we go. Considering my Astro Boy addiction, I have a ton of them in my house, but they're all specifically from Bait, the store we just came out of. When I happened to glance at this little guy, there wasn't really anything else I wanted, but I happened to glance at this guy on the way out. So I don't have this. This will get added to my case.
We're outside the actual Cool Kicks store. Went to the Cool first. Now we're at Cool Kicks.
A little line out front. This time. I got him in my pocket. I got him in my pocket, bro. Stop playing. I called him this time.
I don't even like that motherfucker, but I had to call him. That guy don't even like me. He just likes catching y'all motherfuckers.
So the selection here is going to be a lot more wide than most stores that you see that narrow it down to like the now and what's hype now. So these guys are going to, you're going to find some old classics in here. You're going to find some too that you used to wear back in the day. You know, a couple little gems, used or new.
What's up, man? How you doing?
Living, man. Blessed. Can't complain.
Good.
Y'all need anything, bro? My name is Miguel. I'll be more than happy to help y'all out.
I'm good. We'll let you know, man. Appreciate it.
Got a lot of cool variety here.
You got
sounds okay, bro?
Yeah. I'll let you know if I see something, man, if I got any questions.
So I definitely got some good heat in the display case, that's for sure. Hella Supreme Dunks. Saw a couple Red Octobers, Union, AJ1s. I mean, they definitely got some heat.
Stussy's, Don C's, Red Lobsters, Blue Lobsters.
You want to see anything in the case you got, bro?
What size is this Stussy?
I believe it's a 10, bro, brand new. V&DS. It's not brand new. It's super clean, though.
That's crazy. What else you got on the list? Oh, yeah, you can see a little bit of a little band right here.
I got those 11. I got
Legendary. Little cherry on top.
Cherry!
Anything else you need, let me know, brother.
Yes, sir. Yep, of course. Wow, why haven't you done that with yours?
Exactly, because I was scared of how it was going to look. But now that I'm seeing it, it's like, okay.
This is the Jordan 1 Plot Mid by Edison Chin. These ones have already been cut out, but these panels are removable. You essentially have a gold toe underneath. But when the shoe is DS, it's completely silver all the way around the toe. All of this stuff is covered in this Chinese silk. But once you remove it, then it's got a whole other character underneath. I have these. I was never brave enough to break mine down like this and take out any of the panels. But now that I see it, I'm actually interested and I might go home and experiment. So, super dope. Another one. 11 and a half, never a 12. Oh, hang on. 11 and a half again. Never a 12. Why is that shoe so elusive? From New York to LA, I've been trying to find that shoe, literally. And never a size 12.
So, I'll give you guys my review. There's a lot of old and new, which is cool. I like to be able to go somewhere and find something nostalgic, whether it's used or new, and still be able to find the stuff that's hype as well, that's either not out yet or has released in the last, few months. So I will give them that on selection. Maybe size range, of course. Most cities like we've had the problem is, select size ranges, but it's a lot harder when it's an older piece. One of the things I will amend them on is their customer service. Seems like every time we looked up, somebody's asking us if we need any help or asking if we're good with everything or need to try anything or had any questions. So I will give them their customer service is really good here. Yeah.
I fuck with your store, man. Yeah, Galleria. We don't fuck with you. Plenty of time.
What's up?
All right, that's what's up, right?
For sure. Thank you.
Yeah, sir.
We are at La Ropa.
So I don't know if you guys have been seeing the black trucker I wear all the time, the LA one with the kisses all over it. Same guys.
Pop your little head out. How much are the hats? They all range or no?
So everything on here is 150 and up. These two are actually 1,000 because they're 101.
Okay.
Yeah, so everything else is going to be 150 and up.
Cool. I like this one. I haven't want one of these. You think the cream one, Larry?
No, you're never gonna wear that in public.
Yeah, I'm gonna get that. Just when you tell me no is when I go. Thank you. I appreciate you guys letting us film, man. Alright, so for all y'all who might have seen those Awful Lot of Cough Syrup shirts by Desto Dub, these guys on store now, Melrose, right here, and we're gonna go check it out and hopefully I can grab one of them little shirts.
What?
Are you serious? When did they do that?
Maybe like 3 months ago, 2 months ago.
That's dope as fuck. That's tight.
Yeah, the Roadrunner.
Simo.
Crazy.
He's in here.
He's from Dallas.
Yeah, that's my dog.
He's cool.
He shops at the shop too every now and then.
This is my boy Simo. This is my dog right here. Roadrun Simo. And so just recently he did this collab. And this is it here in person on Melrose. Definitely a dope look. Shout out to my boy Simo. This is tight.
Is that the Waffle House logo?
It's like the plainest I can get.
Waffle House is my fucking favorite place to eat. Are you kidding me?
That's our spot, right?
Why does this have to be so big? This whole hell no. They cook it right in front of you. It's fresh. None of that.
In Florida, they don't.
Oh, I can't tell you about Florida.
Waffle House is not cooked in front of y'all. I don't know.
This thing is huge.
You go turn up.
This sucks. This joke is big.
That's what you throw in the dryer for like 4 hours.
I'm upset. It's just too long. The width is.
The Waffle House.
Hell no. I probably rock it though. It'll probably look good.
Follow me on Instagram at Raven RavynIW. You already know. I just met my new friend. He's all the way from Dallas, Texas. You already know it's an awful lot of cough syrup, awful lot of road running.
There it is. This Raven girl ain't got no style.
You just gotta start.
That's an awful lot of. You see the shoes matching.
Awful lot of cap.
Awful lot of cap.
All right, we out of here. It's all right,
nice to meet you guys.
Nice.
Bye. Have a good day. Y'all be safe out here.
Thank you.
They gotta come back around, bro. They gotta come back around, pop it one time for us. How are you not getting arrested? How are you not getting arrested? There's cops everywhere. This shit don't make no damn sense to me right now.
Dallas, you feel me? I used to do my thing out there in Dallas.
All right, so this is my man Calais. I went to go put his IG in my phone, and I'm already following this man. So this is just 6 degrees of separation, man. This is just how the universe works,
that's
bro.
That's how it works. So. Hey, look, I said he looked familiar. I told my boy, I'm like, damn, he looked familiar. You know what I'm saying? That's crazy. That's crazy. Nice to meet you, bro. That's crazy. Motherfucker.
Yeah. Hey, we'll be back down here tomorrow.
I'm going to follow you too, bro. I got you. All right, be safe too.
Yes, sir.
Pop that shit. Pop your shit.
Hit me, bitch. This camera right here. Yeah, speed up. Stupid bitch.
Pop your shit. We're wilding out here now. They just locked down all Fairfax and Melrose. Many punch the window. Look at this. Look at this guy on the skates.
Oh my god.
Terry.
Please. Oh, see?
Let him go.
The fuck was that?
That was Terry from Reno 911.
Did you catch that?
Yeah.
So, I got these last minute. I didn't know what the hell they were, but they look good. Larry likes these. And then Michael had the idea that we squirt the applesauce on top of the Medellins.
Oh wow, this escalated quickly.
It's like banana bread. Is that how you do it?
Mm-hmm.
The folder?
That's my applesauce ritual every morning. Oh, okay.
Do you think you're like eating something healthy when you do this?
No, it's equivalent to like an apple or whatever.
About that, but I'll tell you this much. I'm not very impressed with LA right now. You guys are too wild for me.
It's not like New York.
New York was a lot more fun. It was chill.
Yeah, I mean, there were some crazy moments there. Don't get me wrong. I wouldn't necessarily call it chill.
Breaking the law.
It was like fun excitement. This is
anxiety excitement.
I'm just having a 3-day anxiety attack.
Alright, we're out here in like West Hollywood at the Bape store. My boy Justin's the one that runs it over there. I've known for a couple years since the first time I went in there like 2-3 years ago and balled out. We've been staying in contact, good friend of mine. So we're gonna go in there and probably spend a bigger bag than we did in New York. Hopefully they've got some of the Hello Kitty drop that they just dropped along with the sneakers that they just dropped. Hopefully they'll let us film. If not, y'all already know what it is. You guys will see the after effects, so let's go. All right, so we in here, they're not letting us film. So I'm about to get one of everything. Small through XL, one of everything.
It's only like a Saturday. Sunday, honestly, any time that works best for you, we'll also be like the first time.
All right, we'll be
back. Yeah, hell yeah. All right, we'll catch y'all, man.
Long story short, Justin was at lunch. I came in, I had another lady helping me.
Justin came back. We really wanted to film. We have somewhere to be because we got to be in Orange County. So he's like, look, I'll hold all this stuff right here. Come back tomorrow first thing, and I'll let you guys film in the store while you cash out. So now we're on the road to Orange County to go holler at our boy Chris for his anniversary and his party for his 9-year company.
Yeah, that's my homeboy Charm Britton. He was on the same show From G's to Gents that Riff Raff was on.
Nice. Right here. Right next to the Ferrari Italia.
Yeah.
About to be around a lot of rich people.
We fit right in.
We're here and we're in Orange County at Chris Noe's 9-year anniversary party and the opening of his new warehouse that he just bought and remodeled and built. If you don't know Chris is an owner of many brands and a collector of many things. I'm really excited and come check it out.
I was like, why is this guy walking towards me?
Charm, what's up?
Hi, Dylan, nice to meet you. What's up?
Larry.
I like the drip, I like the fit. You
Larry
out here
came a long way. I see you, bro.
You've been in the gym.
No, he's really been in the gym.
Getting it in the gym, so I see you, bro. All right, we're about to go in and check out this party.
All right, go ahead.
All right, I'll see y'all later.
Nice to see you, brother.
Hey, guys. Good. Just got here.
Good, bro.
It's all this denim. These are all like samples that are either about to go out or haven't gone out. Like these are at the store right now, but in black. This is crazy. What's up, Chris? You all right?
It's the man of the hour.
This is the guy we were bragging about just a minute ago before we came in. Let him know who you are, Chris.
Chris has leverage. I'm just chilling.
What's up, man?
Yo, all people coming.
Yeah, of course.
Yo.
I mean, you sent the invitation, so I'm going to come.
I told you. Come on.
This shit's crazy. Yo. Show me around real quick.
Yo.
So cool. You got like the real gym floor roofing. The speckle rubber. This shit's tight. I be in here all the time.
Killing it.
Look at this picture right here. Look at that. With Denzel. Crazy.
Good to see you, brother.
Up out here one time for the
glad
one
you guys
time.
Out here, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Scotty.
Hi, what's up? Good to see you, brother.
What's good?
Glad you guys made it out here, man.
So, different side this time.
What's the significance? Is this like, this was the first one?
Yes, it is.
That's the first one.
That's like the classic too, I know. We have that in the store.
Even like the fly, the way the button fly used to be like that.
Damn. Original fucking little Banksy throw.
All right, let's check this out real quick. This is crazy. Who did this?
China Chris?
Yes. Is it China Chris? Yes. Okay, so what Chris does is when he goes to China to do a lot of his collections, he always finds a seems legit pieces whenever he's out there, and I'm assuming this is one of the seems legit China Chris adventures. That's hilarious. Super dope. And then of course the couch. I wanted to get one of these for the house. Larry wanted to come.
Yeah, it's the monitor for me.
That's fucking sick as hell. So what'd you do with the rest of the stuff? You just have it in storage?
Of course.
One day. I mean, it all goes up in value.
All these pillows, these couches, he could resell all that after using it, running with it for years. It doesn't matter. You either get your money back or profit off of it.
Super fucking cool. Thank you for sharing that.
What's your real name?
So let me show you something too. I obviously know you've been fucking with reference.
Right.
This is our new, look, check this out. So I know we've been working with our hats right now. If you feel this compared to our hat that you're wearing right now.
It's more of a thicker wool or what?
We also got a double snap bro. We got this is our new logo we're going to do.
Born to win.
Try this one on.
Okay, this one fits nice too. I can feel it already kind of like shaping around my head.
It's got a little bit of a better structure.
Yeah, see, this fits exactly the same.
Exactly, but better though.
I like how it hugs. Yeah. Does it come pre-curved like this?
Yeah.
We got these hats in last time, like similar to these, and they sold out in like a day and a half.
The one he's wearing right now?
Yeah, we put it out on a Friday, and then by Sunday morning, it was gone.
They go quick, so while you can get them, grab them.
For real. Let them know where to find it.
Got it. At Reference Co., at PCH, fully stocked, so any new drops, go to your local PCH.
And let them know where to find you.
At Brandon_Arias.
It is.
All the new drops, all low previews, I got you guys. Appreciate the support.
Of course.
Kobe jumped over fucking Jordan. Yo.
Come on, with his hand in his pants, come on.
I didn't even see that part. Never that.
What's up, man?
What's up, Lee? I feel like I never see you, bro.
Yeah,
like, literally, you're always behind the scenes. Well, now you got the little one, so now you're really busy. So he's one of the owners as well with Chris. He's just more one of the guys that's just more behind the scenes, and Chris is one of the guys who's like on the front line of everything. All right, so I want to show you guys kind of just what it looks like to run a multi-million dollar streetwear business. There's probably about 5 different brands that are housed inside this warehouse. And this operation is 365, and these guys are operating through hundreds and thousands of accounts through the world. So a lot of the brands you see inside these walls are actual brands that we carry as well in our stores.
As well as fulfilling online. So not only are they sending the clothes to the stores, but they're also sending some of these brands direct to consumer as well, so.
Crisp Denim, which is one of the brands that we carry.
You might seem familiar.
Embellished Denim, I'm sure you guys are familiar with Embellished.
There was a show called How to Make It in America about a brand called Crisp Denim, and that's what this was based off of.
Damn, Phil said he left already. I took a picture in his office. He's gone, and Kevin's not here. Let's play the sad violins right now for Phil and Kevin. You want some mini pancakes? Get a little mini pancakes.
Couple questions for that.
Like, hell yeah, I want some mini pancakes.
Do you want them soggy or semi?
They're better soggy?
Yeah.
Well, then let's sog it up.
Okay.
extra soggy. We're about to have some soggy mini cakes. I'm excited. Little mini cakes. This is really good. And the cakes are warm, so it's like eating a hot cupcake full of flavor. This is like the best thing I've seen. Mini pancakes. Take tips?
Yes, thank you.
Here you go.
Thank you. God bless you.
Yeah, of course. These pancakes are busting for real.
This is incredible. It's a 10 out of 10. And shout out to her for even thinking of this.
Because you know what the best part about this is? Drinking the leftovers when you're done.
Now drink the milk.
Yeah.
Drink the milk. Mm.
We are here catering mini pancakes. We go anywhere to cater at your event. You can find us at Mommy's and Esme's Mini Pancakes. So make sure you guys follow us. Thank you guys.
Okay, so, here we are.
So this is my kid stash.
Okay.
Wow.
Which one is that one?
This is the fruit.
The fruit.
Which is probably one of my favorites.
That's your favorite one?
Yes.
And these are made to order for the most part, and they sell out typically every single time that they drive. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Super dope. Yo, this fly is attacking me.
Robbie. Come here.
He's following me.
One of the things I've always noticed with these was the packaging, how nicely cut and trimmed the Sammies were. Look at that.
A perfectly trimmed Sammy.
Wait, this is really good. The bread was really soft and amazing with the sweet textures. Came out really good.
I like oranges.
And it wasn't too much. Sometimes things are too sweet. It's got too much going on. This is very light, fluffy, like not a lot, you know?
I'm satisfied. Like, I feel like the hype lived up to it.
Like, bro, oh my gosh. In Houston.
So what they do is they do pop-ups. The owner is originally from Dallas, but he's also family members with Chris. and they do pop-ups. So like, they're just, that one says they're in Houston, they do stuff in LA, like different places like that, where they come, pop up, place your orders, and then basically they're gone. They make them to order in each spot. It was amazing. So we're going through all these orders, looking at all these boxes, because a lot of these stores that you see on here are stores that Larry and I used to sell HomFem to when we were doing sales and distribution. So as we're coming along, boop, 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 boop. Matter of fact, all the way down is PCH. Yeah, that's crazy.
So you see how many boxes that is.
10 boxes. Everyone else has one or two.
Because we blow the bag. Party was super dope. Thank you again, Chris and Lee, for having us out, as well as helping to carve a path in this industry. They made it cool to have a sales agency. They kind of transformed a lot in the fashion business and the wholesale side of things, which helped create a path for Scotty and I to be where we are today, from, you know, us taking those steps to having our own agency, and then finally, you know, graduating onto PCH and Private Selection. So very humbled, grateful.
Mad props to everyone in the team, the family, Brandon, Kevin. Yeah,
seeing all the familiar faces everybody in there, man. It's priceless. Proud of you guys, excited, and let's keep going.
Let me kick it. Our boy Jen, who shops with us at the store, who also lives out here, just hit us and said he's got Clippers tickets for the playoffs, and he's got sweet spots for us if we could get down here in time. So we went from Orange County, sped down the expressway, going like 100 miles an hour through in and out traffic, made it here like an hour late, but we're still on time. Staples Center is right down the street. About to go enjoy this Clippers versus Phoenix Suns playoff game tonight. Play the sad violins right now.
Oh, jeez!
Oh, jeezy, Shoreline Mafia.
All right, out here in LA, we just pulled up at the Zolympics. Had to come link with my boy D. For those who don't know, this has been my dog for like 16 years, since I was a young buck, before I could even get into places like this, using this guy's ID to get in.
Oh, wait,
you know
true.
What I'm saying? So it's been a long time coming. I haven't seen D in a while. Had to pull up on my boy right here, so.
Let's go. Hey, I'm about to actually go on stage right now. Let's go. Hey, man, honestly, this dude right here, Larry, is the camera still on right now, and this brother right here, they doing something special. I need to get, you know, hey, all I need to do is get the alerts when the new kicks is dropping, when the fresh police
just
come
let
home.
Let me know what you
shit
need.
That, that's
you
it.
Just let me know
that
what
PCH
you need.
That PCH shit, I need the exclusive.
Let me know. Hey, man. I'm gonna send, as soon as I get back, I'm gonna send you a big pack.
Hey, you know, I love y'all brothers, man. Bounce right now.
Turn that fucking music up. Let's go, put them up. Bounce. See me rolling down the street. Police don't fuck with me.
Oh, they played all that Texas shit up.
I've been watching this man do that for a long time.
Yeah, this ain't the first rodeo, you know what I'm saying? Hey, man, I'm happy they came out here to L.A., man. You know, this is what it is. Big vibes, big energy. Let's go. Let's keep it going.
What can you say? It's been a hell of a day. Leverage 9-year anniversary party. Clippers Suns game 3. And now we out here at the Za Olympics with Dimrick, Tyler Yahweh, and all the fam, bro. Super dope.
You good? You all right? Yes, sir. Let them know what's up, man.
Hey, you already know, it's PCH shit over here. When I'm in Dallas, I go to PCH. This nigga's in LA, he need to get one out here in LA.
Yo, I saw you with the hat on.
Bruh, so much clothes been coming my way, I've been like, I don't even know what to wear no more. I just be wearing simple shit now, like. I ain't got time to dress no more.
You working right now or what? I see you though. I like that. I like that. Get your ass to work. You feel me?
Shout out Green Wolf, shout out Green Wolf.
Alright, man, I get out of here. You can have a great show.
Back outside.
Back outside.
Back outside. Mix a drink with the slip and slide. Yo.
Olympics, you know what it is. Show's over. Tyler Yahweh, OGZ from Shoreline Mafia, Scott Storch, Dimrick, they all killed it, and we're about to go get some tacos, so later. Last night was crazy. Somehow we ended up at the Staples Center for the playoff games. Shout out to our boy Jin, we really appreciate that. Then somehow took a wild turn and ended up at the Za Olympics and where we got to see Larry's homeboy Dimrick perform, our brother Tyler Yahweh, and not to mention
the legend,
Scott Storch.
It was crazy to see it in person, see him playing those keys.
You always especially see the Still Dre one.
Yeah, exactly.
That shit was so crazy. Yeah. And to some of y'all, it might not be anything, but to me, those produced beats are legendary. And to see one of the greatest do it live was awesome.
So now we are on the corner of Melrose and Robertson, about to hit the Bape store real quick. Let's get the camera in there today, watch us ball out a little bit, grab some stuff from the Bape store.
Bart's manager. Yeah, I was over there on Dallas over there.
Okay, where? What's good, man?
Yeah. Got my artist too over here too with me and shit. Yeah, we just dropped a major record with Polo. We got the next one with Trippy coming out, so yeah. So I'm like, yo, I definitely want to.
Hey, I'm fucking the jerk, bro.
Yo, it's holiday.
We got a store in the Dallas Galleria Mall.
When I'm out there, I definitely gotta let you know.
Hell yeah, let's do it. There.
Yes, sir. Back at it, man. The boys in town.
What's up, man? Scotty. I'm from Dallas.
That's graphic designer, super talented creator. She designed our 3-year anniversary logo, so she's sick with it.
Okay, wait. So basically, Justin let us come in here, let us film. It's very rare that you can come into Bape and film. And yeah, so we're about to cash out. We already got a bunch of stuff set aside. probably like over 100 tees. I got these that are about to go out too. I need some more styles. I was hoping to get the Hello Kitty Bapes, but they're all sold out. It's okay though. These fools are gonna take care of me and show me some love. Are you one of the longest people I've worked here?
Or? Like, yeah, me and her, honestly, at this point. Yeah.
So it looks like this one's not on there. This one's not on there. So those are good. I'll take these.
Small 3-2X,
yeah.
I do need a new pair of sunglasses, but I don't think any of these are really going to do it for me.
The vibe?
Nah.
I'm gonna need a full size run of those. Full size run of these. I'll take it all.
It's hot outside, but I might need this one.
Wow.
This might be the one. Decisions have been made.
Small through 2X. And then I just need this in the 2X. It's for a friend. Yo, we balling the fuck out right now. Trying to spin a record bag. So I want to run it up and see what the total is. And if I can, if it's not what I want, then I want to buy some more.
Crazier? All right, bet. What size?
2X. And anything that's a regular ABC camo green. See, Quentin, we got you. We're making special requests for him to go in the back and get shit. My boy actually came through and went in the back queue and found you something. Special request, ABC Black. I appreciate that.
Always. About the whole store. About the whole store.
Stop doing this to him, Scotty.
Let's admire the fits right now. We'll start with the reference code. Shout out to my boy Kev and Brandon. Hom Fam, repping the home team. Down to the Bravest shorts and the UNC women's dunks. And then, of course, you know, I'm Mr. Matchy Matchy.
Larry? Full fit Larry. Sting water. The Nike SB.
To go with the SBs.
With the Sting waters. There's actually a kid who hopped in my DM and he was like, hey, I saw you got the full Stingwater fit. He's like, I have the socks. I'm gonna come by and drop the socks off for you. He came by the store, dropped the socks off. This is the day before we flew out to LA and I left the socks in the car. But I was really about to be full fit Larry with the socks too. Still, shout out to him for bringing those to me. Super dope. Now I can't wait to do it right next time.
Asked him for the shirt for Quentin and he decided to go in the back and he found me a bunch of other stuff. So he got cameraman exclusive shirt. Got him the cool cut and sew pocket camo, found some ABCs, which are real hard to get. And then, of course, the tee that she designed.
Right here.
Hey, let him know who you are, where to find you.
Michelle, but with like a bunch of S's.
All right, we're gonna tag you in this. So she designed this right here, this tee. She does a lot of different designs, and this is the one that she did for Babe. And it just so happens that they had one left in my size, so this is coming home with me.
That's a 3-year anniversary tee, right?
3-year anniversary tee.
3-year anniversary.
Yes, sir.
Cool. All right, we're done. Let's rally it up.
Yes, sir.
Whose shoes are all those? I'm looking at those. What's up?
Those are go-backs. It's nothing heat, but...
Can I see them before we're done? I'm about to look at these shoes. He says it's not a lot of heat, but it's different. I'll take it. What size is this, though?
13.
Yeah, I have to have big sizes. It's hard to get big sizes in Bape Stores. When I get it overseas, it's always sold out. So the fact that I can find some 13s right now is literally impossible anywhere else. So shout out to the boys over here.
Y'all know what time it is, man. We out here in Bape. You already know we're going down. Look at this shit, man. Look at this shit. Man, just bought out the whole store. Young Holiday. Much love to my boy, you know what I'm saying? Subscribe to the fucking channel. If you don't subscribe right now, man, I'm not gonna drop no more music. I'm gonna hit up every artist and tell them don't drop, so y'all gonna starve of music, all right?
How does Off-White and Palace do out there? Does it have a
Palace isn't really, but Off-White, I'll get it in and it's
OD?
Literally gone in seconds. Literally. And then same with Palm Angels. I get it in and it just disappears. And then also, I just noticed these. I need at least like two of each.
Two of these joints?
Those ones are hard. Look, this is how you know you spent a lot, when you fill the whole bag up with the stickers.
We already cleared this? We're good?
All right, man. I think we Gucci.
So in New York, we spent about $8,800 plus the shoes was like $10,000. Today we spent $16,000, so we did $6,000 over New York. Shout out to my boy Justin. Appreciate having you.
Yes, sir.
Now the real question is, this is gonna work? Approved. You thought. All y'all thought.
Oh my God, he's so heavy too.
This is what you're supposed to be living like, honestly. You're supposed to be big bag spinning, you know what I'm saying?
Hold on, I need a scarf. Can I scarf it?
Different.
All right, so we just came in here. We just shut the store down. Shout out to my boy Justin. I appreciate everything.
You see
the business right here.
Everything, man.
Double the order from New York.
I got my scarf on, my receipt scarf, so you know it's real. And we out of here. It's time to go to Chrome Hearts.
Showing love for my boy Scotty. If you come to Vape LA, fuck with me. I'll show you love just like my guy. My Instagram is Jetpack, JETQACK. Tap in, man. I'm showing love, man. Fuck with my people. That's right, man.
Thank you.
Real shit, man. Money or not, man. I fuck with y'all.
Appreciate you, fam.
All right, brother. Hell yeah. Take care, man.
Yes, sir.
Yo, Larry is struggling right now. Look at him doing the little swing
because
with his shoulders.
The bag's swerving over my leg and blocking me off.
So Justin said that last week when Lil Pump went in there, he spent $6,000. Well, guess what? We spent $16,000. So. I think I got you beat, big dog. Lil Pumpy. We're at Chrome Outs right now. And it's appointment only. But Larry knows me and I am the finesse king. So
we got ourselves an appointment.
We got ourselves an appointment. And at the end of the day, fuck you. It was kind of hard to find this place because it's kind of hidden. If you look behind us, all the walls are covered in plants and whatnot all the way to the top of the fence. But we found it. And of course,
Full Fit Larry.
So they happen to have the top and the bottom. Somebody didn't come to pick theirs up, and it was the last one. Happened to be Larry's size.
Not like just a hat, not just a t-shirt. We went Full Fit Larry. I know you see them threads. What's the thread count on this?
The attention to detail inside this store is crazy. From the ceiling down to every single cushion, everything on the wood had some sort of logo on it.
Stamp for it, yeah.
The detail was amazing. It's probably one of the most detailed stores I've been to in New York and Los Angeles together. I snuck a video before they said no of the chapel room.
Oh.
But he did tell us a little bit of the history of it.
It was an iron shop, and so there was already a lot of unique details. And obviously, if you know anything about Chrome Hearts, they do a lot of silver jewelry and things that looks like hard work metal. The vibe that was already in here was perfect.
So the chandelier is the original chandelier. Some of the fence he built, this gate he built himself, his own wrought iron gate he built himself, and other cool pieces inside of there that came with the spot that was there before, whenever it was the ironing mill. Well, that was cool. Back out here on Melrose, we're gonna hit up three spots while we're out here that we missed. First day, Band LA, whenever Eric is ready. But for the time being, we're gonna hit Cookies and Kicks and Round Two. We're looking for some stuff for some personals. Just like in New York where we each bought ourselves a shoe, same thing applies here in LA.
Gotta find some.
I'd prefer to buy mine from Band LA because Eric is my brother and I'd like to support him. So hopefully he has something, but I'm also gonna keep my eye open when we go to Round Two and Cookies and Kicks because they do have good selections and Round Two has a lot of good, old, rare, used things that I like. So let's go check it out. So right outside Cookies and Kicks right now. I haven't been here in a couple years. I think they've expanded a little bit since I've been here. Hopefully we can find something dope. If not, it's cool. Let's go just check out what this guy's got going on. Okay, so first of all, I commend them for the swing ladder. This is amazing as fuck. When I was here, they didn't have that room, and they didn't have these roller carts, and they had a basketball court in here. Louis Vuitton Don, Frack, Jordan 1, Choker Room, JT's, Unions, We the Best Khaled, and the fucking Red Octobers. Michigan's, MF Dooms, looking for old Supreme picture tees and old Supreme box logos, and I want them beat up, but not beat up to where it's like beyond recognition.
Sick.
$7.50 though.
Holy pot
for online for a t-shirt.
I want this so bad. I just don't see a white shirt. Oh, Larry.
I'm gonna tell you right now, the layout was amazing in there. Everything was very well put together, from the shoes on the walls to the categorizing through size of the clothes and to the grouping of some of the other ones you saw in the middle aisles. They had little tags on there that let you know like what each thing was, what brand. The only problem is that it's basically a replica of our store. So they had all the same shoes that we had. They had all the same resale clothes we had. The only thing different is they didn't have a wide selection of grailed items. And there's probably maybe a handful of like five or six actual grailed shoes. So aside from that, man, I think the store is super cool. Eric Kidney, he said we can go meet him at Bandolet. So let's go to Bandolet and say what's up to Eric.
What's up, man?
What are you doing right now?
I work right here. Wow. I live here.
So we've been out here for the last couple days and we're headed towards Bandolet. Our buddy owns this spot, Eric.
No shit.
For reference, he's known us from our Austin days, way before Dallas, way before
for the man.
Yeah, before we even had our own spot. Like he's been rocking with us for a long time.
So if you need a tattoo, let them know where to find you and how to find you on Instagram.
Yeah. We're here, Melrose. I see it's TX Sam Lee.
There it is, TX Sam Lee. You already know what it is, bro. You'll see, we'll meet Critchy tomorrow. He's completely head to toe, front to back, all done by this man right here. So y'all in LA, and y'all Melrose. Hold up, Yellow Wolf. There it is.
DJ Paul.
That's fucking dope, bro.
I did that fucking red thing on MGK's throat.
Oh, wow. Oh, you the one that did that?
Wow.
Okay, we're gonna have to flash back to a picture of that so you guys can actually see what we're talking about.
All right, my
good to see you, Sam.
Yes,
always
love
you, man.
All right,
boys.
Yeah,
later. Let me
know. All right, Full Fit Larry found the fit for tonight. It's right here. Tell me in the comments if that's fire or not.
I would probably go with Daft Punk wave.
Yeah, I mean,
you look like Ant-Man.
I really just need that thing around the shoulders. I'll wear that in the club.
There he is. What's up? How are you, man?
How are you?
I'm better now that I'm here.
What's up?
We're over here at his shop right now. We're looking for some personal items right now. Hopefully we can find some stuff and, you know, Eric will take care of us.
I appreciate it too, by the way.
So we're gonna walk around, we're gonna look around, check some stuff.
See what we can find.
The details in the store so far are really nice. You can see he literally has concrete shells. I don't know how they're holding up inside this wall, but he must have some sort of rebar coming out.
Yeah, there is. Like before they put this in, there was like some major things that they did.
They had to put rebar in there.
Yeah.
And you can see like the 70s style, like ottomans in the middle. Super cool. Now, is everything dead stock here?
Mostly everything.
What size are you? 9.5, 10. I told him my size. He's gonna pick out some pieces. Let's see if he can find something for me. These just came out. New Balance 8. What's your guys' thoughts on these? I think they're pretty fire. I like how they do the shark on the back and they just do it all crazy on the front like they normally do. And then here's the alternate colorway. Alternate colorway.
Have 5 minutes before I go on network.
Before you go on network?
Yeah, the network gap.
What are you doing on there? You doing like a giveaway?
Like a sale. It's like 25 minutes.
Badass. That's cool as fuck.
You want to go on with me?
Yeah. What would I say?
We would just conversate. You would help me actually.
Show me the shoes you're talking about.
I should be the one nervous. Show me it's the back shoes there, but.
So Eric just drugged me on to do the network with him. So for the next 25 minutes, I will be speaking in front of over a million different people from all over. And I guess you could say I'm nervous because he just caught me on the spot. But I do this for a living, so let's see if we can just knock this out the park.
What's up, everybody? So we are here at my store. It's called Bandolet. I actually have a very special guest that I wanted to bring on with me. His name is Scotty. So this guy just popped up out of Dallas. Comes here and he has a YouTube channel, so I wanted to kind of conversate with him while we sell the shoes.
Oh, it's sold out already. What the heck? Did you see that?
Yeah. And sold out.
And it's gone.
The color is beautiful. I love it. Anything that they do that's UNC or University Tar Heel colorways, man, to me, I love.
Dang, I wanted to talk about it while we were selling it, but they're not even selling.
It's cool.
I
mean, we'll run it through. We still got some Syracuse. Anybody want a Syracuse Dunk High? We still got a couple sizes available.
We started as a Facebook group, like basically with no money. no thought, no strategy. It was just a buy, sell, trade platform, which we still have now. Any questions that anybody has?
Scotty just cashed out a babe today. That is correct. I did just cash out a babe today.
They said biggest reselling group in the US. I don't know if that was a good, if that was meant to be a good comment or a bad comment, but it has the...
No, that's a good comment.
It has like one of the...
If you're the best in that category,
some of the elitist resellers in the nation. Like,
I've been a part of the family for a while. I was actually was a part of Bandolet before I ever met you. And I've gotten a lot of different things off of Bandolet. And it's one of those things when you're dealing with sneakers, the community is a really strong community when it comes to sneakers like that. So everybody's always tuning in and trying to take care and showing love and spreading the love and just trying to make sure that everybody gets what they want for a fair price. GCH in the building, you saw
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I saw that.
Somebody just put chopped cheese in here. In Times Square on West 43rd and H Street, Port Gourmet Deli. And if you go in there and ask for the Scotty, it's a bacon, egg, and cheese, chopped cheese combined, and that's what they're talking about in the comments.
You're popular, bro.
I didn't really think I was gonna have some people in there like recognizing me, honestly.
Been rocking with Band LA since 2016. Thank you, appreciate it.
Someone wants to know some of your grails. You got
my grails? Another Jordan 1 low, the Dior lows, right?
Yeah, you're wearing them at Sneaker Con, literally just banging them all up.
It's actually like a thing of mine, like wear your shoes. I'm more for wearing your shoes. I don't want to look in my closet and see all these shoes there and just sit there like, oh, wow, nice shoes, you know?
One of my grails is the Dornbacher 4s, the Supermans. Those are one of my grails. And then I got the Yeezy Zins, the Air Yeezy Zins.
Anyway, we're done now, so. Thank you for tuning in, and hopefully we'll see you on the next one.
Appreciate it, guys.
Oh, thank you, though.
Man, I tried to do what I could.
No, I hope they didn't like be like, who is this guy? Why is this guy coming on right now? Maybe let's get him on network. I'll link you. I'm meeting with them tomorrow here anyway.
That's tight. What's that chopped cheese in there?
Yeah, that's insane.
And then someone else says Scotty just balled out and vaped today. How do they already know that? Do you have some band merch? I want to buy like a shirt, a Band LA shirt. Do you have anything? I need this shirt.
Yeah, we're gonna drop this this week, this coming week actually. We got socks. Yeah.
I want all that shit. Need to get a shoe before I leave though. Where would your Jordans be? Jordan 1s.
Who likes old stuff?
Likes me.
Like SB Dunk old stuff?
That's me.
That's Larry. I'm more of like 10 half 11 for Larry.
11.
Today's turning into a pinky toe no-no. Yo, what's that?
Not your everyday C.
Mm-hmm.
It's a size 7 O2 Michigan.
Yeah, the OG. Wow.
It's the reverse Michigan.
Yeah, reverse ones. Hard as fuck. That's tight. Leather looks nice.
From 99, bro. These are mine, actually. They're from 1999.
Did you show these whenever you did that? No, that was...
Maybe.
I think you or JC had them when y'all did his closet.
Oh, this one. This is cool. This is not like your everyday C either.
Yeah.
That's Larry colors right there.
We were trying to...
This is
Larry, that's
this
your
is
shit,
my vibe.
One
right
of the
here.
Guys who sells to Travis saw that and was like trying to sell, like asking Travis.
That's something. That's unique as fuck.
Yeah,
like.
I need this one.
You don't see this every day.
Yeah. I love the way this is like raw cut like this. There's no padding. It's probably going to tear my ankles
like
up.
Something Travis would wear.
It's worth it. Yeah,
for sure
definitely.
It looks like something Travis would wear.
Okay. That's the one. Man,
that
these are super dope. This makes my day. Thank you for that.
Hold on, man.
That one's a good one, too.
Hey, what you think about these?
Hard, especially with the white laces. It's the white laces that does it for me, actually.
Is this your style?
Nah, not at all, but it's so cool. Oh,
I thought this would be Scotty's style right here.
Nah, hell no. This is my pick right here. Varsity Red Black, 2010. So it's got a little bit of white on it, so I'm not tripping. If it was a solid red or solid black, I definitely wouldn't have picked it up. 11-year-old shoe, and it's in great condition, and it's dead stock, so can't complain. And doesn't put it past me with Eric coming through a clutch for something that I don't have, so.
With the tags on it, from Japan too. The Bix, black
Bic
box.
Yeah.
This one's actually mine, so.
This is actually really
it's
fucking
it's
dope.
Really fire, bro.
This is actually right really, on. This is actually really fucking tight.
It's just black box era, which was like, 06, I think?
06 is absolutely right. Wow. Damn. So it's from 06. Old nice. Shoe, but like it's like the yellow and then the white and then the black and the slight the gray accent right here. Shit is sick, bro.
I'm changing my pick and we're gonna go ahead and go with these.
I think you should go with these, bro.
I'll buy it. Old Larry line, I'll buy it. So cool thing is I'm gonna have a story behind this shoe now because it came from this gentleman right here.
I've had them for a long time. I'm glad that they're going to
straight up.
Hopefully a good home.
Nah, they're going to a good home. And it's still got the Japanese tag on it. So fire. That's cool too, bro.
This is gonna be perfect cool. For those Eric Emanuel pants that I just got.
Anything else?
No, this is it. I'm really happy about this shoe. Are you happy about yours? Yours is really cool, bro. Like, I'm gonna put these on, you're gonna put yours on. People are gonna be like, what are those?
Bro, Scotty, did you touch my drum set?
I know you touched my drum set.
You sound insane. Do you realize that?
Roundhouse your ass. This is literally your mom's life that you didn't touch it then.
Hey, Dave,
yes, sir.
Band LA, we are here on Melrose next to Urban Outfitters. Stop by. My Instagram is PRX. Follow me if you want. Follow me if you don't.
There it is. All right, my dude.
Love you guys, man. Peace out. Shout out to these guys right here.
Yes, sir. Later, man. Enjoy your day.
All right, guys. Just got to round two. Finished up at Band LA. A lot of great options there, some really cool stuff that we haven't seen at any of the other sneaker stores, but we had a little advantage because Eric took us in the back and let us see some things that weren't quite out on the shelf. So round two, about to check it out. If you notice here, they've got two retail stores. One is for the vintage side and the other one is going to be your resale side. So we're going to check everything out, see what it's looking like.
And remember, the one in New York was a homey feel. I liked it a lot. I feel like right now we're going to have a good experience. Let's check it out.
Scotty. Y'all ever need anything, let me know.
Yes, sir.
So far, so good.
This is a cool little selection here. Me, I'm not really into like just t-shirts. Y'all rarely find me just wearing t-shirts. I need pieces, and so those are the types of things I try to find in places like this. So far, I'm seeing a nice arrangement of pieces, things that are not just a hoodie or a t-shirt.
Damn, that's from the earlier release. That's not this one, right? Mm-hmm. That's the one they did before. Yeah, they've done a release before. It's from the first one. It's so small, but I could stretch it. That was gonna be little. Y'all have no more stuff like picture tees?
They don't come around too often. Most of the ones I've seen are usually pretty small.
I've been on Grail trying to find some, and just I don't even care if they're cracked. I wear vintage already, so I feel like I should just start my own little BOGO vintage wave, because I already do it with everything else.
Might as well, right?
Might have to try it out. Well, let them know where we're at and let them know who you are and where to find you.
Hey man, I'm Chris. I'm here around two. If you ever need anything, I'm here. You know, we here, Melrose, LA, whatever you need.
Appreciate that. I got a new little vintage plug, you feel me? I let them know everything that I need and what to look out for, so we're good.
You already know.
Cool, man. We're gonna head out, man. I appreciate it.
Have a good day, man. Y'all be safe. Enjoy. Thank you.
Alright, we're at Vintage by Round Two, which is Round Two's vintage store. They don't have one in New York, they have one here, but one of the things you're gonna see here is you're gonna find a lot of like more rare vintage, a lot of pieces that either are nostalgically from their time or just pieces that you've probably never even seen before. Like you got the $220 Linkin Park, the lady running the store is wearing a vintage Eminem shirt. You know, a lot of these things are gonna be high priced, but definitely worth the value that it's priced at. Let's take a look around.
Oh my god, we might have one.
Yeah, I need it.
Yeah. All it's probably gonna be small though.
Oh, that's literally the problem. Even just anywhere online, it's always small and medium.
Okay.
Yeah.
What is it, black?
Black.
Okay.
Why does it gotta be so small? It's so small.
Yeah, but I think you can make it work.
I need this in an XL.
You can try it on if you want, just to be sure.
No.
Yeah, try it on and come out here, please.
Yeah.
No. You want to see it, Larry? Okay, you want to see what I got then? 2004 Tour, Meteora, and Creed, 99. Anything in the 90s is always a classic, especially if you can get it for like 150 and under, so
We're gonna rock with these two so far.
All right. I feel like I'm 15 again. This is how I. This is me at 15.
I feel like I'm going to the Troubadour tonight.
You're going to the AFI show. That's where you're dressed. Yeah.
Okay, maybe I'll need this just for fun. I'll buy it.
Who was it?
It was Biggie and Tupac, and it says, please stop the violence on the back, and like their birth and death years.
$1,300 she sold it for, and she bought it for $100. That's the real flip.
So that paid my rent last month.
1,200% markup. Wow.
Yeah, right?
Just look for Linkin Park shirts and buy them out of spite for Michael getting upset. I just do it to poke at him. Because he's a huge Chester Bennington fan, and every time I get him before him, he gets upset. So I purposely try to run for the first thing.
We've been listening to Hybrid Theory like all the time lately. Yeah.
Something about Paper Cut just gets me to a place.
There you go. After tax is gonna be $251.85.
Spend my most money on Vintage so far in both series.
All right,
you
guys are
awesome. Awesome, thank you very much.
Appreciate it.
Aaron.
And where can they find you on Instagram?
Aaron Child, just all spelled out. ERINCHILD.
There it is, round two.
Vintage.
The one to holler at.
Thanks, guys.
She's trying to sell her M&M shirt for $1,000.
Yep.
So if one of you guys want to buy it,
thank you.
Buy it,
definitely. Thank you so much, guys. Have a good one.
I've had this before in Dallas, it was really good. That would be me, two sliders.
Cheesy.
So for those of you who don't know, Dave's Hot Chicken, pretty popping spot. I first heard about it from Drake whenever he had it catered to, who was it, Music Awards or who did that? Billboards, I think it was, gave him Artist of the Decade and they catered to the event, so that's how I heard about these guys. They opened one up in Dallas, it's really good.
Man, this looks incredible. Best food I've eaten since we've been in LA. This place gets an automatic 10. I actually couldn't even finish my food and I was sad that I had to throw it away. That's how good this place was. So Scotty says there's one in Dallas. This is definitely a go-to spot. If it's the same thing, then that's an easy win. Dave's Hot Chicken all the way.
Hey, good job.
What's up?
What's up?
Yeah, man. We out here doing what we do best. What's up, man?
What's going on, man?
Hey, nice to meet you, man.
Hey, what's up, man?
What's up, man? Yeah, probably doing the same as you, doing a little shopping.
Yeah.
Running around. We did everything we could do in LA. We went to the Clippers game.
Last like a 36 hours. Playoffs game.
Kicking it hard.
Went to the Scott Storch. He did like live beats in front of everybody. Scott Storch did.
Hey, Zaw Olympics.
Yeah.
So that hoe was smoked out.
Yeah.
It was just bad, bro.
Yeah, I made that whole line.
It was good, it was good.
Last night we went to the Sean Jackson party. Tonight we gonna fuck with Tory Lanez and Hoodie.
Yeah.
Big Hoodie, yeah.
All right.
It's tight. Don't ever go wrong with him.
Yeah, yeah. Tell the vlog who you are. This is Dallas
man,
out here.
Live, man. Hey, uno los of you know, so from the D to LA with it, man. You know, I'm PCH all day with it.
Yeah.
Just playing.
He is, though.
That's the closet. For
yeah,
sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's yes, crazy. Sir.
Hell yeah. Was good running out to y'all,
come grab me one Tuesday. Y'all see me. Y'all see me Tuesday then.
All right, man.
We'll go. We'll catch y'all. We got to get there, bro.
Oh. Be safe, bro.
Leave me hanging.
I don't know. He said, I got one.
Those of you that don't know this iconic fucking bank right here, this is the one that Alex Midler did that 360 flip?
Backside 360.
Backside 360. It's funny because we weren't even looking for that. I look up, I'm like, there it is. I just knew instantly because of all the skate videos I've watched with Cappy and Jordan and even just growing up. Every time I'm in LA, I try to meet up with my boy Critchy. It's always unsuccessful. Critchy's been my dog for years, but he moved out to LA a long time ago. So we made it a point that this trip, whether it's at the end or the beginning, to find some time to get some lunch. And so here we are out in Beverly. So let's go.
My mother.
I like those shorts. How you been?
Good, man.
Good to see
you. My boy Critchy, I was telling y'all about earlier.
What's happening?
So he lives out here in LA now, and so I made it a point to come see him. I know, I feel like every time I come out
it's
here,
been it's been a minute. We miss each other every time.
Every single time. So I literally catch a flight in like 2.5 hours.
I literally made a mission myself. I'm like, I'm meeting Scotty right now.
Yeah, bro. So let him know. Let him know where to find you and everything like that.
At who the fuck's Critchy? I've been seeing him on the come up for what, 12 years?
12 years now.
Since the status 6th Street days, been watching it forever. So, sky's the limit, baby. Shots out.
Yeah, let's go get some food.
Let's go get some Takaya.
It is. I had to see my brother. You know what it is.
Yeah.
Yes, sir, man. I appreciate it. Michael, in the cut. Oh, just like New York, we're boxing everything up. And we're going to ship it back to the store. I also found your shirt. I don't know if that's the one you want to wear. No? Maybe? This is actually a way bigger box than last time.
You want to throw this toothpaste in too?
Sure, why not? One of the bags? All right, cool. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're not gonna let us record, so we're out.
Alright guys, made it back to Dallas. We had a great time in LA. We did a lot of cool stuff, from Clippers game to hitting all the stores. Scotty got to sell some shoes on Network app with Band LA. Pretty incredible weekend to say the least. We're exhausted. It's like almost midnight here in Dallas. We gotta wake up, head to the shop, start all over again. So I hope you guys enjoyed the trip, and we'll catch you next time.
So we just got these badass shorts in, and apparently if you wear them, you can play like Michael
or LeBron.
Or Master Chef.
You can jump higher.
You can get kicked out while filming.